Hi, and welcome in Cloud in 5 Minutes. Today, I want to talk about Application Insight and why should you care? Aussi, si vous préférez, j'ai une version en français de ce vidéo. Cliquez juste ici, en haut à droite. Hello again! Let me introduce myself. I'm Frank Boucher, Microsoft Azure MVP, based in Montreal in Canada. If it's your first time on this channel, you should consider subscribing. Every week, I share with you the best practices about cloud computing. In today's video, I want to talk about Application Insight and why you should care about it. But first, I want to show you how you could add very simply Application Insight to your application. So here I am in Visual Studio, and I just create a .NET Core application using the template that is provided in Visual Studio. To add Application Insight, you just go on your project and you right click, then you go to Add and you select Application Insight Telemetry. Now you just click the Get Started button and you will be on track. So today we'll be monitoring a web application, a web API, and a database. Everything is hosted in Azure. Let's get started. So here it is, the fabulous website that will be used today to generate data. So homepage, we are already in it. So I added a few pages just to have like specific information. For example, here in About, I just use directly a connection to the database, fetch from the adventure work, that is the Microsoft generic database with data, the count of product. In the contact information, that's purely the ASP.NET MVC template page. In product, I'm fetching, so I use the scaffolding to generate the controller, the view, and the query in the database side to get a list of all the product. As we can see, it's very long, it's not optimized. Let's be patient. Ah, finally, so we see all the product are there. Fantastic, woohoo! Okay, the oops page, well, it's an exceptions. I just do a true exceptions in the middle of it. Not found, it's a 404. I didn't put any page over there, so that was just to cause some specific error. And then in test section, I have three calls. So the first one is to call directly the database. Here it is. And now if I try the two others, I will call here, so I will call through the API. I did a wait in the API, so it will be a little bit longer, but it's in the API server side. It's about 10 seconds. Here it is, so now we have it. So the last one, I will do it, but I will cut it the wait just for you because I know it's, you know, the result is the same. So now the slow part is in the database side, just so I want to show you that those information will be reflected in the Application Insight. Voila! Okay, so now let's jump in Application Insight. So this is the overview. A lot of people will spend time, will explain Matrix. I will explain Matrix in another video. Today, without installing anything else in your app, my goal was to show you how you can find what you should be working next. Okay, so first thing I'm going to show you is this purple band that is showing up right now on the top. So if I click on that, we'll see we have many different options showing up. Right now I'm leaving on purpose this off because I want to show you the difference between the old one and the preview one. But other than that, everything is top to the last and greatest. So first tab I want to show you is the application map. So application map is great to see all the components that are involved in your solution. You could also filter if you want and change what kind of application you're looking for. Right now I'm showing everything, so we'll just move it a little bit here. Oh, and you could zoom out, zoom in with using the wheel of your mouse. So now we see different components. I have my availability tests. Sorry, I have always issued saying that word in English. We have like my API, my application, the database is also there. Everything is green right now because I don't generate a lot of error. But if you have one component that generates a lot of error because maybe it's down or maybe because it's broken, then you will see like a red exclamation point here. So the new part, the preview part, you could switch it by flipping here the button. So one thing, right away, we see the design is completely different. I really like it. We can see clearly that, you know, this one is generating a lot more error than the two others. And one thing that is really interesting, in this particular design, we see that my application API and my application, my website, are both connected to a database. So if I don't want that, because I want all calls to pass through my API, because this is my layer to be scalable, then I right away I see a problem. And then when I click on different part, I will see the error, the top, the slowest request, and it will really, really help me to understand what's happening and where is my bottleneck. Second tab is the live metric. I have it open in another tab. So I was letting him running. So we see we have a few steps here when I was showing you the data. Right now it's a little bit blank, of course, because you know it's a website that nobody is poking. It's a fake website. So we see exceptions here, and where I select, I will see more in detail. It's really cool. When you have people going on your site, you will have a lot of information. Right now, because my application was done using .NET Core, apparently not every component is yet available in Application Insight, but it's really coming pretty soon. If you are using the classic framework, .NET framework, you will have a little bit more data. Okay, so the next one I want to show you is the availability. I told you, it's very hard for me to say that word. So this is really useful. You could select multiple. So I have one right now, and I just used the ping test, so I'm poking one specific URL and I select different locations. So I'm calling from here all those countries, and we'll see that, you know, most of the time my time is really good, sometime 44 seconds. Whoa, okay, most of the time it's really good. We have some exception. Yeah, it's really useful to see that everything is okay. You could receive an email if you got more than error, but obviously I didn't do it today. Next tab, I want to show you failure. So failure is really useful to see every time your application fails. And of course, this is for the unmanaged error. If you try catch your error and then log it, you won't see it there. So you will see if you click on it, then you will have more detail about it. And then you say, okay, I have this error. Then you could go in it, check, get the URL, and get everything that was happening. You will have all the detail. This is all the track that is happening. You will see the site, the stack is there, everything. Really, really useful. Also, right now I'm working with operation. You could go by dependency and you will see everything here. It's most of the time it's my API that is causing the problem. Also, you could switch and go by exception and see all the exception. Now, if you click on one, you have a lot more information. The next blade I want to show you is the performance one. A lot of people will use that to see if the application is healthy. Most of the time I use that to find what I should be working next. So right now we see that those are my top slowest requests. So like we discovered together in the demo previously, the get product index is really slow. Yeah, no bets. It was crazy slow. So if I click on that, I will have more. And now I see that, you know, by switching here, I could have a more linear distribution in time to see when it is. And it's always really bad. I could see all my dependencies. So we could see here the problem is in the database. And if I click on it, so we could see it's a full scan table, not a good idea. If I was in a real life situation, I will probably try to change that query, make it more efficient. Maybe I should create a caching to save the result, or maybe I should try to put some where condition or something like that, some indexes, things like that to optimize. A very cool feature, I enable the profiler. So if I go back in this middle portion here, I have two traits available, so I could click on that. And I have the profiler, so I could see every step and where was my problem. So it will give me a lot of information when I'm trying to investigate my problem or try to optimize my website. Another great blade is the browser one. So on this blade, I will see what's happening on the client side. So really useful. We'll have a lot more details. We can see that I am not using Ajax call at all. And you will see. So if you're leveraging anything that is client based, you will see your performance. So since the beginning, it was really like specific time, so we were focusing on the exceptions. Most of the time, I found really interesting and important to know where the user was coming from. So we have a page for that, and it's user flow. So we scroll down a little bit, and we have this user flow blade. And it will help us to know that the user passed from this page to now to the other page, and we'll be able to flow like that and understand the context of the user and maybe understand what he had in this cookie or his sessions. So this way it will help us to understand why it was slow or why we got an exception. Another page that is helpful is, let me find it here, performance testing. So performance testing is really useful, also known as load testing. You could create some scenario, you could do like just ping, but you could also register a more complex scenario using Visual Studio and generate like a real business. So having like the user connecting and then to do some research and click there and there, not randomly, but more like in a purposes. You create different scenario, then you will use those scenario with this test and you will say, okay, you know what, for the next 10 minutes, create me 100 users using that specific scenario, and it will create other tests at the same time to generate different scenario. And with those kind of tests, you will see what's your bottleneck. If it's at your database, maybe you're not doing a good retry policy, because we know in the cloud, this is the most important thing. You must have retry policy because you will have error. Things will be disconnected. A last one is work item. So whatever you're working with VSTS, Visual Studio Team Services, or Git to track your issues, it's really good. You found just a bug, now you could create it directly from the portal and your developer will be aware of it and will be able to start working right now. Pretty cool, huh? So I know it was confusing and it was fast. That was because it's a demo application. I invite you strongly to go with your application and then the data will talk to you and you will see a lot of things and it will help you to find what you should be working on next. I hope you liked this video and I hope it was useful. Don't hesitate if you have questions, reach out. It's always a pleasure to talk to you. Thank you for watching. See you soon.